And now we have a review of the Master Tailor's Poltergeists expansion for Aventuria, the card game, adventure card game. Big thanks to Ulysses Spiel for sending us this, along with other Aventuria products to check out.
Master Tailor Poltergeist, or The Legacy of Dugon de Montrazo, was designed by Michael Palm and Luke Isaac, the designers of Aventuria. This is an expansion for the Aventuria adventure card game, which is designed to be the perfect introduction to Aventuria for 1 to 4 players. A duel with this set will only take about 10 minutes, with the cooperative adventure taking maybe about half an hour. Now, you do need to own the core box to be able to use this expansion. Now, I went searching and I was not able to find an MSRP for this demo kit. It was originally offered as a backer reward for people who took part in the last Aventuria Kickstarter, and I actually don't know if it's actually coming to retail at all.
Now, I have seen this for sale, but only in Europe and not in or with a lot of stock, so it's difficult, if not impossible, to pick up. Still, if you plan on teaching people regularly, well, you'll see.
So this small box expansion provides a beginner adventure, 4 pre-made beginner hero decks that can be used to play either a short duel or an included short but rather fun whimsical adventure. If you're curious to know more about this game, though, like of Aventurio, the game this expands upon, be sure to check out our Aventuria adventure card game review. It was on last week's podcast episode. You can also catch a written review on the blog, and there'll be a YouTube version up soon.
Also, look for the look at the cards and the small instruction book you get with this expansion. Feel free to check out our Master Tailor's Poltergeist unboxing video on YouTube.
Now, this expansion comes in a small card pack, like it's just like a deck of cards. That's it. It's got 55 cards and a small 6-page adventure booklet. The cards thankfully match the quality in the court game perfectly and are broken into 3 different sets of cards. You've got 7 henchmen, all, for fans of Aventuria, you want to know this, have the supernatural, spirit, and servant keywords. There are 3 adventure cards and 4 hero decks. Now, these hero decks only contain 11 cards each. 5 of them are action cards. The 6 are these new endurance cards. Now, I've got no complaints about the components here. Actually, I'm impressed by how much you get in such a tiny little box.
Now that we know what you get with this Aventuria expansion, how about you use this expansion content?
All right, so the point of this expansion is to be an introduction, right? This was actually created originally as a demo kit. To show off a game at cons or for fans to teach their friends or other public play events. But it actually works great for your own personal game group as well. And that's what I did with it, is I used it to teach my wife how to play the game. Now, the reason this works as an introduction is that it presents a much simplified version of the main game. It's much simplified version of the heroes, as well as a really short sample adventure, with some rules removed to make things even easier. Because in a normal game, you've got a hero deck of 30 cards. Well, now you only have a deck of 18 cards. And what they did was they removed a lot of the decision points of the full game while still keeping the feel. Like, you're not going to have to worry about which cards to convert to endurance.
So it's tough when you don't know the full makeup of your deck, or at least don't have it memorized. You don't really know what you're going to need later. So flipping those endurance cards in the normal game without this expansion can be tough and you know, stress inducing.
Yeah, it's actually, to me, it's the most important decision in the game in a way, and it removes that, but without changing the overall feel. Now, they also simplified this game by giving you 4 decks that come pre-sorted, so you don't even shuffle them, and each deck only has 5 unique cards in it, action cards in them, which are the cards you're going to draw for your starting hand of 5. So everyone starts with all their available cards in their hand. The rest are just endurance cards, and they literally say on them, this card is an endurance card. So normally in a normal game, you would draw 2 cards at the start of your hand, put them in your hand, pick 2 cards, turn into endurance. Gone. Don't worry about that. Just take 2 of the cards off your deck and throw them face down in front of you as your endurance for the rest of the thing. Really simple.
Now, while this removes an important aspect of the game, it does so in a way that lets you focus on playing the game without fretting about resource management.
Exactly. Now, when playing a demo or learning game of Aventuria with these beginner decks, there are some rules that are changed. So you follow all the rules of the core game, except the heroes don't have special abilities. So you don't have to worry about those. Critical hits and fumbles are ignored during combat, though they are still used in the narrative phase in the short adventure. Fate points, while you still earn them on a miss, you can only use them to reroll. So no drawing cards or any of the other aspects. And when fighting a duel, you only start with 20 life instead of 40. Now, the beginning of your adventure features a very short narrative phase with one check. So it basically gives you a chance to teach everyone how to make a skill check. And then you get into this rather entertaining and whimsical combat. And I'm going to spoil it just slightly, but I think you can guess it by the name, where you're going to fight some animated garments. This combat features a unique hero action, and you're not going to be able to win just by beating up all this close.
So what are your final thoughts on this Aventuria demo kit?
So I am so glad that when Ulysses Spiel sent us the stuff to check out, they included this demo kit. This small deck of cards and beginner adventure really are a great way to learn the game. I loved how the simplified 11-card decks removed the most difficult decisions from the game while still keeping it interesting. Because just because you don't have to worry about endurance doesn't mean that it's obvious which of your five action cards you want to play and when you want to play them and what you want to spend that endurance on.
Yeah, I have to say the modified rules are in part how I ended up playing anyways. I still haven't actually used a special ability or drawn cards with fate points. It's just less to think about while I've been learning that deck of cards, which is what happens, when you play this version.
Yes. So duels are super fast. Like 20 health is not much. You're going to start with your basic weapons, do D6, right? They are great for learning the basic mechanics of playing the cards, using endurance, taking actions in combat. And the other thing that I thought was cool, too, is they were smart. All the action cards you do get, the five you do get, are handpicked to be basic and simple. None of them have different ways to play in the different modes. All of them are permanent, so you actually don't ever have to worry about timing issues or using cards on another player's turn. And by removing critical hits means you don't ever have to worry about drawing from your deck or discarding cards either. You're going to have these cards in play or they'll be in your hand. This lets you or the players focus on the core rules without getting caught up in card combos and minutia. Now, the cards you do get are a nice mix. Like you have some buffs, you have some weapons, you have some cards that allow you to make checks and some armor. That does actually, I was surprised how well they do a good job of showing off each of the four different characters and how they're different from each other. Like the small subset of the cards they give you do a good job of at least kind of showing how those decks play in the full game.
Yeah, all the basic mechanics are there, just distilled down to what matters most for easy learning.
And I gotta say, I was really excited to try this adventure. If you watch my unboxing video, you can see my mounting excitement as I check out these henchmen cards. Because I'm like, oh, wow, look, these are all like sets of clothing and they're medieval clothing. And like their actions are like flutters about frantically or flutters about in an elegant manner. And I'm like, oh, I want to play a game where I battle sentient clothes. That sounds awesome. And now having played it, I am really happy to see that it wasn't just beat up the clothes. It could have very easily done that. That's what I expect from a demo of a card game like this. You're going to show me a quick combat where I just beat the bad guys and it's not going to take too many rounds. But I'm pleased to see they didn't go this way. And I'm not going to spoil where they did go.
Yeah, they really do seem to enjoy putting thought and plot into their adventures, including skill checks that both make sense and have impact.
Now, another aspect I appreciate from this is that it could be more than just a demo kit to teach it, because all of these are like valid Aventuria cards. They have a symbol in the corner to indicate they come from this set, but that's it. Most of the hero cards are non-unique cards that you could use for deck building if you combine it with the core set. Similarly, there's nothing stopping you from taking the henchmen here and throwing them into your henchmen deck. Means that you could end up running into magical garb in future adventures.
So if you really want more bad guys to fight, you can decide after you run into them the first time.
That's true. You get to see them. Now, what I like about these henchmen, too, besides being animated clothes, which is just cool, is the fact they're only threat level 2. Now, there are no threat level 2s in the core box. So these are a simplified, easier monster that I think are cool because they're going to fill out that threat level. Again, listen to the full review if you don't know what I'm talking about with threat level. But like if you do put any animated clothes out, they're going to be kind of like a bonus, right? When they're mixed in with the rest of the poltergeist and undead, be like, oh, now we got a couple easy to defeat opponents that are there while not really watering down to the deck because it's such a low threat level. You would have to draw 3 of these cards to equal a 5-level threat orc.
Now, I find there's a real Bedknobs and Broomsticks vibe here, though I realize I have probably just seriously dated myself by that reference.
Yeah, I haven't seen that in years. Now, one complaint I do have about this box is you need the core set. This is not a standalone thing. This does not include the full rules. You're going to need things like the hero cards, the tokens, the health trackers, the fate tokens, and all that stuff. Now, as far as I know, the only way to get this kit is through a Kickstarter where you get the core rules. So I guess it's not a problem, right? They're going to come together. But if it is for sale in the future, it's not like this is a starter set, which does lead to the biggest problem. Is, as far as I know, the only way to get this is from that Kickstarter or people who got it in the Kickstarter selling copies. Now, that only ended like earlier this year, 2021. So it is possible that this will be sold separately in the future. They've definitely marketed it as a standalone product. Like if you look at it, it's got the barcodes and everything on it to be sold. But I actually don't know if you're going to be able to buy this. And even going on BoardGameGeek, all that's there is the German version. They don't even have a listing for the English version yet. Now, I did see some copies for sale in the BoardGameGeek market, but as of today, those are gone.
Yep. No, I ran into it listed on some European sites again, but your mileage may vary. And yeah, who knows, maybe on the next time they put out a Kickstarter, they'll offer it as an add-on again.
This is the kind of thing, too, I think once cons start up, you'll probably be able to pick up at like an Origins or a Gen Con. Now, the reason I'm saying this is I honestly think Master Tailor's Poltergeist is a perfect demo kit. And you're going to want to try to find a copy of this because this is a great introduction to the world of Aventuria. It's a fantastic way to not just learn the game, but to get you excited for more. It does a great job of presenting a simplified, quicker version of the game without losing the feel of the full game.
Yeah, no, absolutely.
Now, if you are thinking of picking up Aventuria, try to find a copy. That's the best I can say at this point. If you already own Aventuria here's I think, the important question, and you know how to play, you still might want to pick this up. For one, the short adventure's cute and fun, and it's good for a nice filler. Like, if you want a filler version of Aventuria, you're not going to have to play for an hour, hour and a half to get through this adventure. So it's a nice little cute filler, and most of the cards can be added to the core set. So it'll let you do some deck building without having to cannibalize the other decks. And I do like the fact the henchmen can be thrown in with your henchmen deck. Plus, you never know. You may want to teach the game to someone new or bring it out to a local game store. This would be a great place to be able to pull the cards out, because Aaron mentioned, and use it to teach the game again.
Yeah, if you are the local teacher of games, it's definitely something that's good to have in your back pocket if you want to push other people into buying more Aventuria and having more fun yourself. Well, that's it for our review for Master Tailor's Poltergeist for the Aventuria Adventure Card Game. I welcome you to also check out the written review of this expansion over on the blog at tabletopbellhop.com.